our last half hour, we talked about finding the perfect romantic gift for the man in your life. And now we're learning how to prepare that special Valentine's Day menu. So here with our grocery list is food expert Andrea Bucket. Good to see you.
Hey.
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 Oh, hey. Hey, you. What's happening? We're talking aphrodisiac foods, aren't we?
We are.
Okay, yeah. So you're my date for the day.
You got it.
All right, so what are we looking at here? This is sort of the spread that you should have in your household?
Absolutely. Okay. So I'll try not to use too many euphemisms today.
I'm going to be trying to filter myself big time.
So yeah, you know what? Food and sex are the cornerstone of existence, really, right?
Absolutely.
So, yeah, so it's no wonder that humans have been trying to up the ante with their food game.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
There's so much stuff to talk about.
There is, and a lot of it is based in folklore. Some of it has some fact to it. There is some nutritional benefits of the food that we're going to talk about that is the reason that it gets you in the mood.
In the mood. Okay, and one of the things that I at least know the starting point here, which are oysters, right?
Absolutely. I think oysters are a fan favorite for sure. And it goes.
Are they, though? Or is it just something we like buy into?
If you don't love oysters, chances are they're not going to get your partner all worked up. They're going to do the opposite.
Okay? They probably won't. There won't be any sexy time.
No, they won't be. But they say that Casanova ate up to 50 oysters a day.
And look at how that worked out
for him. He betted half of Europe, apparently. So it worked for him.
Mm-hmm. We're probably all related.
But the thing about oysters is, so you have to think about food the way it looks, right?
Yeah,
Does that get you in the mood?
No, this is my hard part with oysters because it just doesn't look that appetizing. But
the other thing is you can feed your partner oysters. So it's sexy.
Do you want to do this?
Let's do this.
Should we put something on it?
No, let's not do it. Just let's
Seriously?
Naked oysters.
Really?
Yeah.
Like unclothed. Okay, ready?
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. But I couldn't get out.
They're briny. But if you pair some vodka with that, you're good?
Do you have any? Is that vodka?
If you put some vodka with it, alcohol actually helps to sort of,
it helps everything.
Loosen up the mood, as it were. But not too much alcohol.
No, never, never. Okay. You gotta be, me.
Yeah.
Never too much. Okay.
I don't know. I think you and a little bit of alcohol will be fun.
It is fun.
Yeah.
Game on. Okay, so what's this going on
here? So this is a chocolate elixir. So we all know that chocolate is an aphrodisiac. It's an old-time favorite. But it is called Theobroma in Latin. So it's the food of the gods. So who doesn't want to feel like a god or a goddess?
Especially on Valentine's Day.
Exactly.
Okay, so how do we do this?
So this is a chocolate elixir. It is steeped with some cream. There's some orange zest in there. Let me see if I can get this in there just like that. There's some cinnamon in there. Cinnamon and
hot,
chilies.
Right? I can see the steam.
It is.
I always worry about pouring hot things into glass because one time I poured a hot and it just like...
That wouldn't be romantic. So this also has some chili peppers in it. And chili peppers help to increase circulation and get the mojo going. All right?
Cheers. Gosh, our date's going so well.
It is.
So far. So far, so good.
So that's lovely. It's nice. It's a great for dessert as well.
It also, it's like a good glass of wine. You smell it first.
It smells
amazing.
You want to get all your senses involved, mm-hmm. But you don't want to eat too much. That's the other thing. There's nothing like, that'll squash the mood than being full from a big steak dinner or something.
That's true.
You want to think of things that are sexy, things that you can feed your partner.
Stages, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, stages. Okay, this one.
So this is a favorite. Game on. This is an edible body paint. Okay, so again, we're going with a chocolate
theme.
Where
do you even get this? Not your local grocery store.
No, you're going to turn on the music. You're going to pour yourself a glass of red wine.
Yes.
And you're going to make some edible body paint, okay?
You can do this by yourself, too. Who needs somebody to hang out with?
Well, it depends. If you're single on Valentine's, you might want to do it yourself.
You might want to do it. It's like a full night of fun. Okay, so how does this
work? Am I going to paint this on you? So you look.
Yeah. Okay, wait.
Let's do this little part here.
Let me undo myself.
I've seen some body paints that have chili peppers in them. I do not recommend you put chili peppers in this, unless that's your thing.
But it would burn the skin,
Right? It would increase sensitivity.
Okay, how about I just stick with my hand?
All right, what are we going to write
on here? Don't get crazy here.
And then I'm just going to paint you. I don't know what I'm going to do here.
Okay. All right, there we go.
And then it's you have to figure out how to get it off, Lindsay.
this is like what? No, you know what? I'm going to save this. I'm going to let it harden, maybe. Save it for later.
You let it harden.
Okay, that's one idea.
Yeah, and it also has honey in there. So, the birds and the bees, they used to put grooms in rooms and make them drink honey to
They used to put grooms in rooms?
Well, grooms and brides as
brides,
well, right? Because
it
ups their energy and, it's a lot of great things. A lot of B vitamins in there to help to calm the central nervous system.
Awesome.
Then we have figs and pomegranates. Again, figs are, they look like certain body parts when you look at them and they're fresh. Maybe not right now. They've been steeped in a little bit of red wine.
As they should.
But certainly this is something that you can feed to your partner. It's kind of sexy.
Oh, I love that. And you've got the big brie too. And I know brie's not necessarily an aphrodisiac. But
if you're going to feed that to your partner, it's kind of rich and sexy.
Yeah.
We have pomegranates on there. So anything that looks like it's from seeds. Mm-hmm. So it looks like it's seeds. It symbolizes fertility.
Right.
So it should make you think of having, romantic evening.
You know what? At the end of the day, this is all so much fun, and it could be a really fun night with your partner, and to get creative and to have different stages. Maybe you could do little stations in your kitchen or something with some champagne, whatever you want to do. Toast it, right?
You got it.
Toast it and roast it. All right, you know where to find all the recipes. Andrea, always a pleasure to see you.
Thank
I'm
going
to somehow get this off with a cracker, perhaps. That's another thing we've invented in this moment. All right, thanks so much. Recipes on yourmorning.ca.